Right, are you ready to roll?
Yes, mate.
Right, Aki Kareem for British Boxers. We're down here at Nuffield Health Centre in Parswood. We're here with Liam Cullen, who is a blast from the past, let's say. Firstly, Liam, just tell us a little bit about your background and sort of where you started boxing and how you ended up in the pro ranks.
Right, mate. Been around forever, in and out of gyms. Most gyms in Manchester, there's a few I haven't been to yet. But started Jim Egan's in Withenshaw, so I boxed as an amateur for them. Close to 12 years ago. You should spar with Tyson Fury and a lot of good lads in there. Stephen Sean brought me through, and then sort of walked away for a little bit. Ended up turning over with Joe Gallagher in 2010. I had a few with Joe, so I was unbeaten in three in 2010, and then got ill towards the end of the year, so got absolutely wiped out with pneumonia and swine flu combined together. I thought I had AIDS.
That's crazy.
Honestly, like, I thought I was literally, like, so many of the symptoms match up, I was in such a bad way.
Yeah.
But lost enough weight that I would have been like heavyweight sound. So I missed out on the prize fighter. So I was having a call off Joe saying that I've got you a shot at prize fighter. And so I was too ill to do that anyway. So yeah, walked away for a little bit, went to try and earn some money. And then I went back, boxed with Arnie Farnell, who, like, top trainer, done loads for us. And I lost my first one, had one on it, and sort of wasn't focused and whatnot. And again, walked away for a little bit, but like I was saying to you earlier, like, you never walk away.
Yeah.
At the minute, looking to get in a gym, and it's going to be cruiserweight, sort of putting a little bit of size in here, a little bit stronger than you used to be. And just go looking at getting set up in a gym and getting back and getting
fighting. We've got an exclusive here for British Boxers, really, haven't we? That Liam Cullen's making his comeback.
I've been away for a little bit, but I'm ready to come back. So
yeah,
cruiserweight's on notice.
So cruiserweight is obviously it's a division which it's so funny because I've just interviewed some cruiserweights today. It's not always been a division that's been that glamorous in the UK, but it actually is now. You've got loads of local prospects in Manchester and in London and various other places of the country, Chorley, etc. And it's a good division to come back into the mix in, really, isn't it?
Yeah, there's a lot of sort of younger lads come through now who are out there that, might still be amateurs last time I boxed, and they're now sort of undefeated professionals. And I want to get back amongst it and see what's left in the blast from the past.
Now I know obviously you're doing your modelling and working as a personal trainer and all that sort of stuff as well. Have you been in the zone though? Have you been sort of mixing up with a bit of boxing as well in the last few years?
Always doing bits. So yeah, you throw weights around and you want to look all right and whatever. But yeah, the reality is the training in a commercial gym is like, don't compare to a boxing gym. But my mind's always on it. I'm padding everyone and always looking at little things to use and do for myself. And back work's always there. Little bits of sparring here and there back at Jim Egan's beginning of the year and there. Yeah, a little bit, sort of, a couple of weeks back. So, but yeah, definitely ready to get back amongst it.
So, in terms of like your comeback and looking for a pro gym, have you made up any minds, or are you still sort of thinking and seeing what's out there and whatnot?
Looking at sort of like my old amateur club again. He's now pro am. Stephen Sean are training pros now. So yeah, that's probably my first port of call is to go and see them again and see what's available in terms of sparring. Sparring's the one, isn't it? And, everyone knows you've got to get back in, you've got to get sparring, you've got to take a few shots, and that's where all the sharpness comes and everything comes off the back of that. So terms of conditioning can be dealt with at work, trying to find my way into a gym and to try and gel with a trainer, I think can help me, and vice versa, that can bring me on or bring me back.
Well, listen up, trainers, all those trainers out there. If Liam Cullen is looking for a trainer, get on him, right? Send us a message.
Can't see my phone going mad.
You're 31 now, obviously that's not old. I mean, the higher you go up in weight, the older you can be, really, can't you?
Yeah.
But does it sort of, does that play in your mind that you need to really just get on with it now?
Well, now or never. For me, I'd probably say I've got like a 4 or 5 year window where I can get back in the mix and really focus on boxing. My job allows me to do it, I'm flexible. It is just literally getting in the gym, getting the sparring, and then getting to be able to box. And then the hardest bit about boxing is the salesman aspect, selling tickets. So,
yeah. I mean, the sort of what's motivated to get back into the actual game then? And you're living you're doing other things, you're making money elsewhere and etc. Why is it you want to get back in the ring?
It's always there, I don't know if. It's always, you always want to fight, you've always got that little bit of angst or whatever, and you've got to use it and miss the game, love the training. You just, we're coming here and you do your 3 sets of 10 and you bench press and jump on the treadmill for a little bit, it's not the same, is it? And combat, I've been doing it since I can remember, karate as a kid and whatever, hitting someone, getting it back, nothing makes you feel more alive than fighting. Combat sports, the only sport I know.
Not going to affect your modelling then, if you get a broken nose.
If it does, I've missed out on jobs before for it. Send a little selfie, I've got 2 black eyes, big fat nose, just one in a minute,
Well, listen, mate, we're going to miss your, your selfies on Instagram and all that. But
that is not stopping. Hanging them out every day.
But, we wish you all the best. And, it's good to hear that you're coming back. And it'll be interesting because you've already sort of been there and walked the walk. So it's not going to be like you're phased and daunted by the game or anything. So
miss it, die, you get amongst it.
Yeah, quality. All right, well, listen, it's good to talk to you. Liam Cullen making his return to the Cruiserweight division.
Can I give one more shout out?
Give a shout out, go on.
Right, Instagram, so I'm always hammering Instagram. My personal page is at Liam M. Cullen. It's all modelling and bullshit with Bird and all that sort of stuff. But I've got a fitness page, FWD_fitness. We're working on building a little bit of a program for putting your own training sessions together, a little bit of an online PT vibe. So if you want to give that a follow, give it a shout.
Have you just used this interview to plug your...
plug everything.
Yeah, all right.
Anyone needs any photo shoots?
Yeah, anything else?
Pre-black eyes, broken nose, give it a shout.
All right, there you go. Listen, Liam Cullen, we're gonna follow this story. I'm telling you, the second you get down, get a gym fixed, we're coming down there.
Yes, nice.
All right, nice one, man. Nice to see you, Liam Cullen. I'm Aki Kareem, British boxers. You know the score. Power.